Hey guys, Professor Dave here. Today I want to talk about E2 on cyclic systems.
He knows a lot about the science stuff, Professor Dave explains.
So let's revisit the E2 reaction, recall a few things about this mechanism. So we know the base is going to extract the proton, the electrons in the carbon-hydrogen bond will form the pi bond, and the electrons between the carbon and the bromine will leave with the bromine, and there's our alkene product. Now, one thing we didn't talk about before is it is the case that the proton that is being extracted must be in an anti-conformation with respect to the leaving group. So if we take a look at this Newman projection, so let's say that we're looking this way down the bond right there. So we're going to see the hydrogen up, directly up, the methyl down to the right, the hydrogen down to the left. And then on the back carbon, that bromine is going to be down, the hydrogen's up and to the right, and the methyl is up and to the left. So this is the Newman projection looking down this bond. Now it is the case that the proton being extracted and the leaving group must be in anti-conformation with respect to each other. So that's the 180 degree dihedral angle. Now the reason for this is we know that there's a pi bond forming. And if we recall, what a pi bond is it is a lateral overlap of electron orbitals that are the unhybridized p orbitals. And so it is the case that the only way that the overlap can happen is if these bonds are anti to one another, because that's where that's how the orbitals are going to overlap so as to form the pi bond. So in any other position, it wouldn't work. Let's say that the methyl group, let's say we rotate 120 so that the methyl is up top here, we cannot have elimination in that configuration. Now the thing is, with a linear system, now we know that sigma bonds are rotating all the time. So if at any given instant the methyl group were anti to the bromine, that's okay, because that's simply going to rotate until a proton is in the correct position to allow for elimination to occur. But with cyclic systems, it's not so easy, because we cannot have constant rotation, right? So let's take a look here. So we're going to look down this bond on our chair structure here, and we're going to see that on the front carbon we've got a proton down, methyl up and to the right, and the rest of the ring to the left. On the back carbon we're going to see we have the bromine up, and we have the rest of the ring down to the left, and then we have the implied hydrogen, that's that one, down and to the right. Now, so we know, we just figured out that in order for elimination to occur, the proton being extracted in the leaving group must be an anti-conformation with respect to one another. And on a ring, the only way for this to occur is if the two groups are both axial. So the bromine has to be axial, the proton being extracted has to be axial here, because the equatorial positions are always going to be anti to the rest of the ring. So here's the equatorial hydrogen back here. That is anti to the rest of the ring on the front part. Here is the methyl group over here. That's in the equatorial position on this carbon. That is going to be anti to the rest of the ring in the back. So there is no way for a proton in the equatorial position to participate in elimination. So we know that we're always in equilibrium between the two chairs. So there's a lot of things to think about in terms of which chair is going to be the one that will promote elimination. So if the leaving group is equatorial in one chair, that's not going to work, right? We have to have that axial. And then once we have it in the axial position, it is only protons that are in on beta carbons and also in the axial position. So this hydrogen, let's use this. This hydrogen and this hydrogen are available for elimination, but the other hydrogen on this carbon, that one's not going to work. So it is no longer the case that these two equivalent protons are both available for elimination. Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials, and as always, feel free to email me with questions, professordaveexplains@gmail.com.